External Affairs Minister S. Jaishanker is currently on a two-day visit to Mauritius. On Monday, he met with the Prime Minister of Mauritius, Pravind Jugnauth, and discussed important bilateral issues. The highlight of the meeting was the free trade agreement signed between the two sides. This is the first FTA India has signed with any African country. Issuing a joint statement, the Prime Minister of Mauritius hailed the Comprehensive Economic Cooperation and Partnership Agreement, saying that the deal is far-reaching and should unleash new opportunities in trade, economic cooperation and investment.
This landmark agreement is far-reaching and should unleash new and expanded opportunities in trade, in goods and services, investment, economic cooperation and technical assistance. The SECPA will encourage Indian entrepreneurs to invest both in Mauritius and across the whole region, thus consolidating our ambition of making Mauritius a strategic regional economic hub and a centre of excellence.
The Indian External Affairs Minister echoed the same sentiment. Jaishanker said that the free trade agreement will enable Indian investors to use Mauritius as a launchpad for business expansion into continental Africa. Let's now take a quick look at other important issues that was discussed during this meeting. The Indo-Pacific region found its mention in these key talks. The Prime Minister of Mauritius said that the two leaders discussed ensuring peace and respect for the rule of law in the Indo-Pacific region. He also mentioned the efforts of the Quad nations. The Prime Minister of Mauritius said, and I'm quoting, "I welcome the renewed commitment of the Quad countries in upholding rules-based international order underpinned for respect for territorial integrity." The two leaders also discussed India's increasing defense engagements in the Indian Ocean. India and Mauritius have agreed to extend the defense line of credit by $100 million and $50 million, respectively. The other key points discussed in the meeting were India's support for Mauritius's exit from the FATF grey list. Mauritius was among the largest beneficiaries of India's COVID-19 related assistance. And as per the latest talks, the African nation has also requested for 200,000 COVID-19 vaccines from India. This will be the second vaccine consignment to Mauritius from India. Mauritius is considered as an entry to African investments. Earlier this year, China signed a similar free trade agreement with Mauritius. The agreement has its implications on the geopolitics of the Indian Ocean and the region overall. Traditionally, Mauritius is considered as India's key Indian Ocean partner, and the growing ties between the African nation and Beijing will have its impact on India's influence in the region as well.